Episode 12. Title of the Radio Enabled Learning course is Energy Physics. Unit 3. Wind Energy. In this episode 12, first we would like to see classification of WEC systems. First, there are two broad classification. First one is horizontal axis measurements. The axis of rotation is horizontal and aeroturbine plane is vertical facing the wind. The second one is vertical axis measurements. The axis of rotation is vertical. The sails or blades may also be vertical, as on the ancient Persian windmills, or nearly so as on the modern rotor machine. Then they be classified accordingly to size as determined by their useful electric power output. First one is small scale, up to 2 kilowatt. This might be used on farms, remote application and other places requiring relatively low power. Second one is medium size machine. That means 2 to 100 kilowatt. These wind turbines may be used to supply less than 100 kilowatt rated capacity to several residents or local use. The third one is large scale or large size machines. That means 100 kilowatt and more than 100 kilowatt. Large wind turbines are those of 100 kilowatt rated capacity or greater. They are used to generate power for distribution in central power grids. There are two subclasses: single generator at a single site. Second one is multiple generator sited at several places over an area. As per the type of output power, wind aero generator are classified. First one is DC output. The sub classifications are DC generator, alternator, rectifier. The second one is AC output. The sub classification are variable frequency, variable or constant voltage AC, constant frequency, variable or constant voltage AC. As per the rotational speed of aero turbines, these are the classified as constant speed with variable pitch blades. This made implies use of synchronous generator with its constant frequency output. Merely constant speed with fixed pitch blade, this mode implies an induction generator. Variable speed with fixed pitch blades, this mode could imply for constant frequency output. Field modulated system, AC-DC, AC link, double output induction generator, AC commutator generator, other variable speed, constant frequency generating system. Wind turbines are also classified as per how the utilization of output is made. First one is battery storage. Second one is direct connection to an electromagnetic converter. Third one is other form, that means thermal potential of storage. The fourth one is interconnection with conventional electric utility grids. The system engineering seeking to integrate WECs will naturally be interested in the latter case, but should be aware the WECs offer other options as well. Now we can discuss about advantages and disadvantages of wind energy conversion system. Advantages of the wind energy are: it is a renewable source of energy. Like all forms of solar energy, wind power system are non-polluting, so it has no adverse influence on the environment. Next one is wind energy system avoid fuel provision and transportation. The next one is on a small scale up to a few kilowatt system is less costly. On a large scale, cost can be competitive with conventional electricity and lower costs could be achieved by mass production. Next, we will discuss about some disadvantages of wind energy are wind energy available in dilute and fluctuating in nature. Unlike water energy, wind energy needs storage capacity because its irregularity. Next one is wind energy system are noisy in operation. A large unit can be heard many kilometers away. The next one is wind power system have relatively high overall weight because they involve the construction of a high tower and include all gearbox, hub, pitch changer, generator coupling, shaft, etc. For large system, a weight of 110 kg per kilowatt rated has been estimated. The next major drawback disadvantage is large areas are needed, typically propellers 1 to 3 meter in the diameter deliver a power in the 30 to 300 watt range. The final major disadvantage is present system are neither maintenance free nor practically reliable. However, the fact that high reliable propeller engines are built for aircraft suggest that the present troubles could be overcome by industrial development work. Advantages of one-bladed rotator: simple blade controls, lower blade weight and cost, lower gearbox cost. Next one is counterweight cost less than a second blade. Counterweight can be inclined to reduce blade. Next one is pitching bearing do not carry centrifugal force. Blade root spray can be large diameter, that means more rugged. The disadvantages: vibration produced due to aerodynamic torque, unconventional appearance, large blade root binding moment, starting torque reduced by ground boundary layer. 1 per rev fuelless torque produced due to flapping. Number of blades: wind turbines have been built with up to 6 propeller type blades, but 2 or 3 bladed propeller are most common. A 1 bladed rotator with a balancing counterweight has some advantages, including lower weight and cost and simpler controls. For the multiple blade, however, the starting requires high wind speed and vibration and other forces can be large. Turbines with 3 blade have been used in several WEC machines. In order to avoid the vibration experienced with 2 bladed rotator, these vibrations are related to turning of the rotor in the order to face into the wind. It appears, however, that the problem can be overcome by controlling the yaw rate because they cost less fabricate in large size and are capable of operating with a high tip speed ratio. Two bladed system are receiving major attention. Then we move on to blade design. Wind turbine blade have airfoil type, cross section and variable pitch. They are slightly twisted from the outer tip to the root, where the blade is attached to the hub to reduce the tendency for the rotor to stall. In a few devices, the blades had a constant chord length. constant distance from edge to the other. As a general rule, however, better performance is obtained with blade that narrower at the tip than the root. The motion causing the wind due to the motion is rotating of the blade. At the tip of the blades of a modern wind turbine, the velocity is about 6 times the wind velocity. This means that the blades are set rather flat at a small angle with the plane of the rotating and almost at right angles to the direction of wind, so that the effective wind properly approaches from head of the leading edges. At other parts of the blade between the tip and the axle, the velocity of the ideal set of the airfoil is at a greater angle to the plane rotation. Ideally, the blade should be twisted, but because of the construction difficulties, this is not always achieved. In the large two-bladed wind turbines, the blades are inclined at a small angle called coming angles to the vertical. The design decreases the bending load on the roots of the blades and lessens the danger of falling the supporting tower under the serve wind condition in the very large rotor consisting of a single piece mounted at the midpoint. There is no conning angle. A fundamental problem in the wind turbine design is to allow for many forces to which the blades are subjected during normal operation. In addition to vibrational stress resulting from rotation, there are several extraneous forces that arise from wind turbulence, directional change in the wind, variation of the wind with height, wind gust, gravitational force, the pressure of the tower. The blade must be constructed and attached to the hub in such a manner as to withstand these forces. Consequently, aerodynamic performance is sacrificed to some extent in the design of a rotor with adequate strength. Although the wind power of a rotor increases with square of the slip diameter, there is a practical limit to the size. In the first place, the mass of the blade increases rapidly with its dimension. As a result, the wind power available per unit mass decreases as the dimension of the rotor are increased. The tip speed ratio tends to decrease correspondingly. Furthermore, the wind drag force generally increases with the blade size. The limiting dimensions depend on the design and constructional materials, but the maximum practical diameter of a two-blade rotor may perhaps be in the range of 90 to 110 meter. In order to provide both lightweight and adequate strength, aircraft industry techniques as used in connection with airplanes and helicopter propellers have been drawn upon in the design and the construction of wind turbines. For small rotors in particular, the blades can be made laminated wood, possibly covered with thin skin of aluminium. Rotors up to 34 meters in diameter have been fabricated from plastic reinforced with glass fiber. More conventional aircraft type blades are usually made from aluminium or aluminium alloy. They consist of long central span with ribs at intervals covered with an aluminium skin. The very largest rotor blades have been made of steel to provide adequate strain. Then we move on to yaw control. The area of wind stream swept by the wind turbine is maximum when blades faces into the wind. This is achieved by control arrangement is which when the wind direction changes, a motor rotates the turbine slowly about the vertical axis so as to face the blade into the wind. For localities with prevailing wind in one direction, the design of the turbine can be greatly simplified. The rotor can be in a fixed orientation with swept area perpendicular to the predominant wind direction. Such a machine is said to it cannot be rotated around a vertical axis perpendicular to the wind system. Most wind turbines, however, are yaw active, that is, say, as the wind direction changes, they will track the changing direction of the wind. In this case, a motor rotator the turbine slowly about the vertical axis so as to face the blades into the wind. The area of the wind stream swept by the wind in then a maximum. In the smaller turbines, yaw action is controlled by a tail vane, similar to the in the American pumping windmill. In the large machines, a servo mechanism operated by a wind direction sensor controls the yaw motors, keeps the turbines properly oriented. Next, we move on to wind stream variation. Wind speed variability must be considered, especially in the design of the large WEC machines. For a given turbine, there is a minimum wind speed called the cut in speed, at which rotation is allowed to start the cut in wind speed and the rated wind speed at which the generator produces its rated power. The rotation rate is maintained constant by varying the output of the generator. At wind speed exceeding the rated value, the rotor speed is held constant, automatic adjustment of the pitch of the blade. At very high wind speed, the blade are feathered as in aircraft and rotation cases. The wind speed at which this occurs is called the cutoff speed, that means furling speed. The electric power output of the generator is essentially constant. The variation of the generator power with the wind speed is by the full lines. The dashed curve represents the theoretical variation without any control of the rotation. At wind speed above the rated value, part of the available wind power is not used or spilled as consequence of changing the pitch angle of the rotor. Consequently, in this respect, the system is somewhat less efficient than one in which the rotor speed is allowed to increase with wind speed within the limits. However, machines of the latter type are less easy adapted to connection into an electric utility grid. By designing the system to suit the wind condition at a particular site, the wind power loss by spilling can be relatively small. At higher wind speed, the speed of rotation of the blade, that means, and of hub to which they are attached, tends to increase. In fact, for a given wind speed, the rate of rotation must exceed a certain value if a stall with loss of power is to be avoided. However, a changing speed of rotation will generally not provide the optimum condition for generating constant frequency alternating current. One solution to this problem is to allow the turbine's speed to vary and to couple hub with the mechanical or electrical system which generate a current of constant frequency from a variable speed input. For example, variable frequency alternating current may be generated and rectified to produce direct current. The direct current can then be used to generate constant frequency alternating current by means of an inverter. If the electricity produced by WEC machine is to be used for battery charging a direct current generator up to about 20 kilowatt may be connected directly to the rotor hub, the speed of rotation of the turbine is then immaterial provided it is not so low as the stalling, although it results in some loss of efficiency. An alternative solution used in some aero generators has been preferred. Between the cut in wind speed and the rated wind speed at which generator produces its power, the rotation rates is maintained constant by varying the output of the generator. At wind speed exceeding the rated value, the rotor speed is held constant by automatic adjustment of pitch of the blades. At very high speed, the blades are as in an aircraft and rotation criteria. Over the range from the rated wind speed to the cutout speed, the electric power output of the generator as stated remains constant. Then we move on to turbine tower system. As stated earlier, the horizontal axis wind turbines are mounted on towers and there are wind forces on the tower. Both upwind and downwind locations have been used so that tower design is an essential aspect of the overall system design. Some important characteristics of 7S rotor. First one is self-starting. Second one is low speed. The third one is low efficiency. Next, we will see about some important environment aspects. First one is electromagnetic interference. Second one is noise. Third one is visual effects. Fourth one is bird life. Fifth one is risk. These are the some important environment aspects. Then we move on to safety system. Safety system of the wind turbines comprise the following features. First one is the computer. Second one is emergency stop. Third one is revolution counters. Fourth one is wind velocity. Fifth one is lightning rods. Finally, we will discuss about some important questions of wind energy system. The questions are: what is the basic principle of wind energy conversion? Second one is derive the expression for power development due to wind. The total power density in the wind stream. Next one is describe the main consideration in selecting a site for wind generator. Describe with neat sketch the working of wind energy system WECS with main components. How are WECS system classified? Discuss in brief. Discuss the advantages and disadvantages of wind energy conversion system. Describe horizontal axis type aero generators. Write a short note on applications of wind energy in detail. Describe the different schemes of wind electric generator. Describe the generator system. Also describe the generator control scheme. What are the advantages of vertical axis machines over horizontal type? Describe the rotor for relatively low velocity wind. Dear student, now we are in end of the unit 3. In next episode, we will start the new unit 4.